Short-term recurrence methods can be very powerful. For example, in high-performance computing and linear systems of equations. CG is primarily designed for symmetric positive definite matrices. CGN doesn't have that restriction, but convergence can be slow. BiCG can converge faster, and we will now see how BiCG can be derived directly from other short-term recurrence methods. The preconditioned gradient method involves a system matrix A and the preconditioner M. This algorithm is very well understood if you assume that both A and M are symmetric positive definite. But the algorithm can actually work anyway, even if these assumptions are not satisfied, like we will have in this construction here. To derive BiCG, we'll consider an adjoint system consisting of the transpose system matrix A transpose and the right-hand side B hat, which will be arbitrary for the moment. We can merge these two, the original system and the adjoint system, into one equation, and BiCG can be seen as PCG applied to this adjoint system with a particular preconditioner. Now we're going to translate each step in PCG by first partitioning the vectors. So R becomes R and R hat. This partitioning directly leads to a translation of, for example, the X update, which becomes an update in X and X hat. Similarly, the update in P becomes an update in P and P hat. Due to the fact that the preconditioner has this specific structure, Z is equal to R hat. That means that we can translate the R update equation into an update in Z and Z hat. Note here that we have the matrix A and A transpose in BiCG. We can translate the update of beta by just using the fact that R is Z hat, and we get an expression involving Z and Z hat. Similarly, we can update alpha with Z hat, Z, P hat, and P. We now translated every step in PCG into one or two steps in BiCG. Since BiCG can be derived from CG, it shares some of its properties. Unfortunately, there's no nice convergence theory as we have in CG. But we do have an orthogonality property in CG, which carries over to an orthogonality property in BiCG. It's a bi-orthogonality property. CGN is also derived from CG, but with a different modified system matrix, namely A transpose A. The condition number of A transpose A is typically much larger than the condition number of the B matrix in this derivation. This can be seen as one of the justifications why BiCG performs much better than CGN in practice, although CGN is much better understood theoretically.